is called Clue, which stands for Children Looking Undercover for Energy, where we are exploring and doing fun activities with all the different types and forms of energy. And in today's video, we are focusing on radiant energy. So let's get started. Radiant energy is also called light energy because it is found in heat and light. Examples of this type of energy is fires, light bulbs, and fireflies. The sun is the Earth's largest source of radiant energy. This is also called solar energy. Light is all around us and gives us energy. We get energy from the sun through its rays, which provide us with nutrients and vitamins that we need, such as vitamin D. So the sun comes out during the daytime and the moon during the nighttime. How this works is because the Earth is round and tilted on an axis in which it rotates. This means that it is day and nighttime depending on where you're at on the Earth. So the sun is slowly moving across the sky throughout the day. It rises in the east and sets in the west. And what this is showing is that is the Earth slowly rotating. So when you are facing the sun, that is daytime, but when you're rotating, which we are, it takes 24 hours for the Earth to fully rotate. You are then facing away from the sun, in which it becomes nighttime. So for today's activity, what we're going to be doing is we're going to be using the sun and its radiant energy that it gives off to make some solar mitts in which we are going to measure how much radiant energy is collected in the form of heat, depending on what our mitts are made out of. So let's get started with today's activity. So let's start off with the supplies that we're going to need for this activity. For this activity, you are going to need 4 pieces of black construction paper. You are going to need some tin foil, some tape, and you also might like a pair of scissors for this activity as well. So let's start off by making our black pair of solar mitts. So we have 4 pieces of construction paper here, and I'm gonna line them up 2 and 2 and just make them nice and even. And then just taking our tape, what we're gonna do is we are going to tape all corners of our mitts except for the part where we are going to put our hands in. So I got my tape here. We're gonna put tape along here, and along here, but leave room so we can slip our hands through here. And we're gonna do that with both sets of mitts. So after you have your tape all along your mitts, they should look something like this, where your hands just slip nicely through them. All right, so once your black mitts are made, you're going to be making your tinfoil mitts. So go ahead and just tear off about 4 pieces of tinfoil, and you're just gonna do the same thing that you did with your black mitts. For tinfoil, you might not even need tape. You can just kind of fold over your edges so that they are nice and secure, so that all you have to do is just slip your hand through the bottom of them. So it should look something like this, where you can just slide your hand in and out of, and go ahead and just repeat that with your second mitt as well. So then your next step is you're going to take both sets of your mitts outside. Hopefully it's a nice and sunny day out for the best results. You're just gonna lay it into a sunny area and leave it out there for 10 minutes. So go ahead and set your mitts outside and wait 10 minutes. So here are my mitts outside. If it is a windy day, you might wanna set like a rock or a pencil on there or something to help keep them from blowing away. But you just wanna put it in a nice sunny area where it can soak up the sun's energy for about 10 minutes. All right, so it's been about 10 minutes and I brought both pairs of gloves back in. So starting off with our tinfoil mitts, I'm just gonna slide my hands into them. And they feel kind of toasty. The insides of them are definitely much more toasty compared to the tops of the mitts. But then let's try our black mitts on. And just by touching their black mitts on the tops of them, I can definitely tell that these ones are much warmer. So you should be able to notice from your experiment too that your dark black mitts are a lot warmer than your tinfoil ones. And this is because darker colors absorb more heat from the sun compared to brighter ones. Brighter colors often reflect and bounce off that heat. If you notice, our tinfoil is very reflective. So it was bouncing off that sunlight compared to the black paper, which was absorbing it. You may also notice this occurring if you're ever outside in a hot day and you're wearing a darker colored shirt. You may notice that you feel warmer a lot quicker compared to if you're wearing a lighter one. This is also explains why things such as solar panels are darker colored, because they absorb more of the sun's energy that way. Well, I hope you had fun with today's activity, and now no more more about radiant and solar energy, and also have a fun and easy activity you can do at home. Be sure to check out all of our other videos and activities that have to do with energy sources or for some more fun STEAM activities. Thanks for watching!